During last week's parliamentary sitting, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, lashed out at the European Union Parliament for antagonizing the construction of the East African crude oil pipeline. The EU Parliament passed a motion advising EU membership not to render diplomatic and financial support to Uganda's oil and gas projects. Border riders from the divisions of Kampala, which are Central, Nakawa, Lubaga, Kawempe and Machinde, have protested the European parliamentary resolution, asserting that it's a risky process to the people and the environment. In their petition to the European Embassy, they condemn in the strongest terms that this resolution is meant to block the socio-economic development of Uganda. John Sechitoleko, the secretary of Kampala Border Riders, noted that Uganda is an independent country free from neo-colonialism.
We are here today with the purpose of seeing the EU coming in to sabotage the production of oil, of Ugandan oil. So we think that it is the right time now to come in to make sure that we stop this neo-colonialism, because it is like Uganda is an independent country with its minerals. We hope that when EU comes in and try to sabotage the production of oils, we don't think that it is actually it makes sense. So the reason as to why we have mobilized ourselves, we made this petition to the ambassador or the European Union ambassador to show that we are also concerned in the matters of oil, in the matters of the Uganda as a country. So please let these European countries know that Uganda is an independent country.
After reaching the embassy, only three representatives were allowed in the embassy gates to represent the rest as the demonstration went on outside. The police intervened to calm the situation in the city. In February 2022, the government, through the Uganda National Oil Company, together with Total Energies EP Uganda, Sinok Uganda Limited, and the Tanzania Petroleum Development Corporation, announced the final investment decision to mark the beginning of the detailed engineering, procurement and construction phase by the joint venture partners, and to see the first oil by 2025. However, environmental activists and EU are opposed to the construction of the crude oil pipeline, citing its negative effects on the environment. Story by Sharon Nabasirie for the news.